This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, let's start. One second. Right, so this is the example we have discussed yesterday. We have seen on change of event a second example. So here what you have done is we have declared an internal table and we are retrieving some 500 records to the internal table. Right, so we are sorting it on land one, and we are displaying it. So whenever a new country arrives, whenever a new country is encountered, we need to display that particular country, and below that you have to display the corresponding customer data. So when I execute, I got the data something like this. Okay, so this is customer country, this is customer country, something like this. So country wise we got the data. Okay, so let me open this once again. So yesterday what you have done is we declared an internal table and we have retrieved some 500 records into the internal table at a time by using one select query. We have retrieved all the 500 records into the internal table. Once the data is retrieved into an internal table, we are sorting that internal table data based on the land one, and we are looping the internal table and displaying the data. As part of this loop and loop, we have used on change of event. Whenever there is a change in land one, this event will be triggered. So we are displaying the land one, and after that we are displaying the corresponding customer data. So this is what the output I got. Country wise we got the customers. Now let me do the same example in a different way. So I took an internal table yesterday. So now what I'll do is, see the change. I'll use something called as select and end select. Select and end select. So my requirement is something like this. I have to display the data again, country wise. We have to display the data again country wise, but we have to get the data only of which countries: Argentina, Australia, and something, Berlin, something like this. Okay, so yesterday we have retrieved some 500 records and we got the data into internal table. Now without taking internal table, I want to display the data. Okay, so let's see how to do it. So I'll be using something called a select and end select. So in the output, what are the fields we require? We require land one, we require customer number, customer name, and city. So let me declare one types declaration first. Okay, I'll declare the types declaration. Types begin of ty underscore something customer. I'll take the fields customer number type kna1 hyphen customer number, then I'll take land one, type kn1 hyphen land1, then I'll take another field name1 type kn1 hyphen name1, then ort01 type kn1 hyphen ort01. Close the types declaration, end of TY_customer. Now yesterday what we did is we have declared the internal table. So internal table means which is capable of storing what? Multiple records. So by using one select query, we have retrieved all the 500 records into the internal table. Now I'll not take the internal table, I'll take only the work area. So I'll declare W_customer type TY_customer. Only work area I declared. Okay. So now I'll say select what are the fields you want to retrieve. Customer number, land1, name1, ORT01 from KNA1. Okay. So if the target variable is the internal table, we would have said into table what? Internal table. Okay. Where land1 in. Already we know. Whenever you are comparing with the range of values, we have to use what? In operator. So where land1 in, what country customers you have to retrieve? Argentina, Australia, and what something? Berlin. So where land1 in, AR comma, AU comma, what? BE. Okay. So this is very much valid if it is an internal table. If this is the internal table. But this is not an internal table, it is a work area. So I cannot use what into table. So when I do syntax check, I got an error. W_customer is not an internal table. Occurs specification is missing. So the W_customer is not recognized as what internal table. That's why I'm getting the syntax error. So what I'll do, since it is a work area, it can store only what single record. So I cannot use what into table. But here we are writing the select statement where land1 in what set of range of what values. So this select statement, it will retrieve multiple records, but this work area is not capable of storing what multiple records. So when I do syntax check, I got an error. What is the error here? See, incorrect nesting before the end of the program. The control structure introduced by select must be concluded with what end select. The control structure introduced by select must be concluded with end select. So if I use select single, I'll get only what single record, but each country might contain what n number of customers. So I need to retrieve multiple records. So if you are retrieving multiple records, the target variable should be internal table, but I have not taken internal table. I took what work area. So that's why I'm getting an error. The structure introduced by select must be concluded with what end select. So what I'll use something called as what end select. Select and what end select. Select end select is a looping statement. What this select end select will do, it is something like this. So this is your ABAP program. Try to understand this ABAP program. So on executing this ABAP program, we are sending the request to what? Our database system. Okay, we are using what? Select and what? End select. So what this select and select will do? Select and select will act as what? Work area. It will act as work area. So what happens is a work area is created with how many fields? Some 4 fields, Kunnar, land1 and name1. So this is your application server. Okay, in this application server, a work area would be what created. So assume that this is your work area, okay, which has got how many fields? Some 4 fields. It has got some 4 fields. So what are the field names here? Customer number and land1, then name1, and then what? ORT01. What is the name of the work area? W_customer. So this is my work area. So when you say select and select here, select and select will act as a loop. It will act as a loop. So when it will act as a loop means what? It will retrieve only one record per request. So when I say like this, it will come, it will retrieve the first record. It stores that record in the work area. It stores that record in the work area. If it is successfully retrieved, it will enter the loop. Now I'll display the data, right? What? W underscore customer hyphen what are the fields? Customer number. W underscore customer hyphen land one, W underscore customer hyphen name one, W underscore customer hyphen ORT 01. So inside this select and select, I'm using what? Write statement. Select and select will retrieve only what? Single record per request. It will retrieve the first record. It will be retrieved into the work area. If it is successfully retrieved, it will enter this loop. It will print the data from the work area. Since it is a looping statement, again a new request is sent to what? Database server. Okay, one more select statement is sent. What this second select statement will do? It will retrieve the second record in the queue. Okay, so that record will come and sit in what? Work area. What happens to the first record? It will be overwritten. Work area can store only what? Single record at any point of time. The second record will be overwritten. It will enter the loop. It will print it. Like this, select and select will act as what? Loop. It will act as what? Loop. Understood? So this is your select and what? End select, which will act as what? Looping statement. Select and select will retrieve only what? One record at a time. So since it will retrieve only one record at a time, I took the target variable as what? Work area. So when I execute this, let's see whether we'll get the data or not. I'll activate. When I execute, yes, I got the data. I got the data. What data I got? All the customers whose country keys are either Argentina, Australia, or what? Something Berlin. Okay, so when I execute, I got the data, but my data is not in sequential order. This is Argentina here, again Australia, again Argentina, Australia, Argentina. So it is not in a sorted order. Okay, so if it is this internal table, I would have used the sort statement. Once the data is stored in the internal table, we can use the sort statement to sort the data, but this is not an internal table, it is a work area. So what I'll do, while retrieving the data itself, I'll try to sort the data. So here already I covered this. I will use a class called as order by. Order by what? Land one. Means it is going to get the data in the sorted order of what? Sorted order of what? Country key. That is land one. Order by land one. So when I execute now, good. So you can see here I got all the Argentina records. I got all the Argentina records first. Then if I scroll down, these are all the Argentina records. Then these are all what? Australia records, AU. Then these are all what? Berlin records. Okay, these are all Berlin records. But what is my requirement here? I need to display the country only once. Under that country, I should display the customer data. So what I'll do, inside this select and select, I will use a event called as on change of W underscore customer hyphen land one. Whenever there is a change in the land one value, I'll display only the land one. So I'll say right customer or country key. I'll simply say country key is what? W underscore customer hyphen land one. Hyphen land one. Okay, end on. End for on change event is what? End on. I'll give some color kind of thing. Format color 3. I'll switch off the color here. Format color off. Okay, and here also I'll not display the land one again. I'll display only customer number, name one, and what city. Here I'll give some color. Format color 7. I'll switch off the color. Format color off. Okay, I'll leave some 5 spaces so that it will display under the land one. So when I execute this, no errors. Then I got the data. Country key is what? Argentina. Right? I got the customers of Argentina. Then if you scroll down, there are all the countries of what? Customers of what? Argentina. Like that. Okay. So let me try to debug. So what you have to understand is select and deselect will act as a loop. Okay. So I'll put the breakpoint here. When I execute, yeah, if you see this W underscore customer, W underscore customer hyphen Kunnar. Okay, it has got what? Four fields. W underscore customer hyphen land one, W underscore customer hyphen name one, W underscore customer hyphen ORT 01. So this is my data. Okay, so when I say FI, select and select will retrieve only what? Single record. So when I say FI, yes, I got the first record. I got the first record into my work area. On change of land one, yes, it's a new country key, na? First time this event is triggered. It's a new value for land one. What is that? Argentina, this event is triggered. It will enter that event. It will print that country key. Okay, it has displayed what? Country key. Then under that, we are displaying the corresponding customer number, name one and what? ORT 01 displayed. So you can see here, it has displayed the customer number, customer name and customer city. Done. Select and select is a loop. Na? Again, control goes what? To the select statement. Again, what this will do, it will retrieve the second record in the queue from the database. Okay. When I say FI, what is the second record? This is a customer number. Country is again what? AR. Same value. Na? So since it is the same value, since there is no change in the land one, this event will not be triggered now. It will not enter the on change of event. When I say FI, it is not entering inside the on change of event. It is directly displaying the customer number, name one, and ORT 01. So I got the data. Like this, select and select will act as a loop. So here, without using the internal table, I am able to deal with what? Multiple records. But this is a huge performance issue. Select and select will act as a loop. Okay, and select and select will retrieve only single record per request. Since there are too many select statements, okay, it will increase the network traffic, which will increase the burden on the database server, which will decrease the performance of the applications. That is the reason it is generally recommended not to use what select and what end select. It is recommended not to use select and end select. So how you can do, how can avoid this? So this is a performance issue. So I'll just comment this. What performance issue? Not recommended. So what I'll do now, instead of using select and select, I'll use what? Internal table. So first let me declare the internal table data T underscore customers type what? Table of what? TY underscore customers. Then here I'll say see the change. Select customer number land one into table. What is the internal table? T underscore what? Customers, where land one in so on. So order by, again order by will increase the load on the database, because order by statement, what it will do, it will try to perform the sorting on what? Database itself. It will try to perform the sorting at the time of data retrieval itself. So which will again increase the load on database server. So I'll not use the order by class. Okay, done. Here I'll say if size of RC is equal to what? Zero. I'll get the entire records into the internal table. Now on the internal table, I'll use a sort statement. Sort T underscore customers by land one. Then I need to loop the internal table for display. Na? Loop at T underscore customers into what? W underscore customer. Done. Then on change of W underscore customer hyphen land one, I'm displaying the land one. Then end on, and then here below that I'm displaying the corresponding customer data. That's all. Okay, I should not use any select and select, else I'll just give a message, no data, end if. Okay, here I need to close the loop and loop. So what is the advantage here? We are using only one select statement. Only one time the select is what? Executed. The entire data will come into the internal table. We are looping the internal table and we are using the on change of event inside the internal table. So when I execute, what is the error? T active underscore customer, not customers. Done. So no errors. Done. When I execute, I got the same data. Country wise, we are getting the customers. Okay, if I debug this, when I put the breakpoint, right, if you see the internal table, when I say FI, in one select query only, I got all the 115 records. We are looping the internal table and we are doing it. Understood? So how to avoid select and select? By taking internal table as a target variable, so that by using one select query, we can get all the data. Okay, it is recommended not to use select and select. So what I am trying to show in this example is, I have used on change of event inside select and select. I have used on change of event inside what loop and what end loop. So on change of event can be used in any of the looping statements. I can use in while end while, I can use in do end do, select end select, and loop end loop. So any questions in this, please ask me. Any questions? Right. Okay. Now let us see. Either type of report. So this is my requirement. Whenever I run my report, I should get the data something like this. Okay. We have the item data table, the sales document item data table, VBAP. Okay. So each sales document, might contain what n number of items. Each sales document might contain n number of items. For that item data, okay, so under each sales document, I need to display the item data. Each item will have the price. No? So at the end of that sales document, I should do the sum total of that particular. Item value. Suppose this 4970 has got what three line items. Every line item will have item price. At the end of that sales document, I should do the sum of the item values and display it like that. After doing all the after processing all the sales orders, at the end I want the grand total of all the items of all the sales documents. This is the overall requirement. So I need to fetch the data. Where is the item data stored? Sales orders item data is stored in what? VBAP table. So I need to get the data and display the results, something like this. Hope it's clear. This is a requirement. Okay. So here, if you see, I'm not generating any selection screen. I don't want any selection screen, but I want a fixed range of sales document. When do we go for selection screen? When you want the user to enter the range, we'll go for select options. Select options will generate the selection screen for reading the range of what input values. But now I don't want the user to enter the range. Always the range should be fixed. Okay, that fixed range should be given in the report itself. We should not allow the user to provide the range. So let's see how to do it. Done. So here, if I use select options, we know that select options will generate what? Selection screen. Select options will generate what? Selection screen. But I don't want the what? Select options. I want what? The range should be fixed. The range should be between 4970 to 4975. So what I'll do is, similar to select options, we have something called as ranges. Ranges. I'll say R underscore web length type. Okay. I want to get the data from which table? item table, sales document item table, VBAP. So if I go to SC11, we have what? VBAP, right? In the VBAP table, sales document item data table, we have a field what? VBLN. What is the data element of this? VBLN underscore VA. I can refer to the data element or I can refer to the field itself. So here I'll say R underscore VBLN. It's not type here. I'll say for what? VBLN underscore VA. Save it. Check it. No syntax error. Yeah, I'm getting an error. VBLN underscore VA must be a flat structure. Okay. So it is not allowing us to refer to the data element. So I'll say for VBAP hyphen VBLN. Let me check the syntax. Yeah, no errors. Right, I need to refer to the field itself. It is not allowing me to refer to the data element. So what is this ranges? Ranges is also similar to select option. But the difference is select option will generate the selection screen where the user can input the range of values, but ranges will not generate the selection screen. When do we, as ranges and select option will have the same structure. What is the structure in the select option? Sign, option, low, and what? I. Ranges also will have the same four fields, okay? So when do we go for ranges is when you are sure about the range, when you don't want the user to enter the range, when you want to fetch the data based on a fixed range, we'll go for what? Ranges. So what I'll do now, somewhere here, I'll say in the startup selection event, the default event is what? Startup selection event. I'll say R underscore weblen hyphen low is equal to, I'll give that value directly. What is that? 4970. Then R underscore weblen hyphen I is equal to, equal to 4975. Done. And I'll say what happened, R underscore weblen, because ranges is also what? Internal table, right? So I'm hard coding the range in the program itself. So when do we go for ranges? When you want to fetch the data based on the fixed range. Like this, we can give the data. If you want multiple ranges, again, here only internal table can hold multiple records. So what I can do here, here I'll give another range, 4980 to 4985. Like this, I can give multiple ranges in the program itself. Done. So the ranges is prepared. Now I need to fetch the data, fetch the item data from VBAP table. What are the fields I want? I want weblen, item number, material number, and net value. These are all the item details from which table? VBAP table. So let me declare the internal table. So types begin of TY underscore sales items. Okay, I'll take the fields weblen type VBAP hyphen weblen, then item number PYSNR type VBAP hyphen PYSNR item number. Next, material number type VBAP hyphen material number. Next, what? NETWR type VBAP hyphen NETWR. Then I'll say end of TY underscore what? Sales items. Then based on this, I'll create an internal table, data T underscore sales items, type table of TY underscore sales items. Then I'll declare a work area, W underscore sales items, type, the type name is TY underscore sales items. Okay, so once the range is prepared, let me get the item data. So somewhere here, I'll say perform get sales items. Instead of directly writing the select statement, I want to put it in a subroutine. So I'm calling the subroutine perform get sales items. Subroutine get sales item does not exist. Create the object. Yes, I'll choose the main program. Let me write the select query. Okay, select VBLN, what are the fields I want to fit? Item number, material number, net item net value from VBAP table into table. What is the internal table? T underscore sales items. With what field I have to compare? Where? Weblen in. When you're comparing the select option, also we use in operator. When you are comparing the ranges also, you have to use what in operator in R underscore weblet. Understood? So I repeat once again, ranges. What is the purpose of ranges? It is similar to select options, but the difference is select options generate the selection screen where the user can input the range of values, whereas ranges doesn't generate the selection screen. We go for ranges when you want to fetch the data based on the fixed range and you don't want the user to enter the range. Okay, there are other difference also we'll see now. So first, what I'm doing here, I'm getting the data into my internal table comparing the ranges. Let me check whether I'll get any errors. No syntax errors. When I execute, I'll get the runtime error. Yes, I'm getting the runtime error, ABAP programming error, SAP SQL in ITAB illegal sign, invalid value in the sign field of value table for in ITAB operator. Invalid value in what? Sign field. So where is error here? See, okay, in the sign column, use only one of the values. In the sign column, use only one of the values. What are the possible errors for the sign field? Inclusive or exclusive, I or E. So you can see the error here. Error will be in the select query. Yes, error is in the select query. So what is the error is? We know that in case of select option, what is the default value for the sign field? Inclusive. The default value for sign field in the select options is inclusive. But whereas in ranges, we don't have any default value for the sign field. So you need to manually provide it. So what I'll do somewhere here, I'll say R underscore weblen hyphen sign is equal to I. I means what? Inclusive. Repeat this process for what? The second one also. R underscore weblen hyphen sign is equal to I. Done. Let me check whether I'll get any other errors, runtime errors when I execute. Yes. Invalid value in what? Option field of the value table. Okay, so again we got the error in the select statement because there is no default value for what? Option. Okay, the option column should contain only one of the following values, equal to, less than, greater than, all those. The value is not allowed here. So in case of select options, the default value for select for option is what? BT, nothing but between. But whereas here explicitly we have to provide it. There is no default value for option field in case of ranges. So also option equal to, I'll say BT between. Here also I'll say between. Okay. Now let me check. When I say F8, yes, when I say F8, I don't have any errors. So I'm getting the data into my internal table. Now what I'll do after executing this subroutine, I'll say if T underscore sales items is not initial, if it is not initial, okay, I'll just display it, perform display what? Sales items, display the sales item. I'm calling a subroutine, else I'll just give a message, no sales data, no sales items, type what? I. So let me write the logic for display here. I'll double click on the subroutine, does not exist. I'll choose the main program, continue. So where is the data available now? Data is there in the internal table. So let me loop and display. I'll say loop at T underscore sales items into W underscore sales items end loop. Okay, let me try to display that. Write W underscore sales items hyphen what? Weblen hyphen weblen. Then W underscore sales items hyphen item number hyphen material number hyphen net value. So I'm just displaying the data as it is. I'm just looping the internal table and displaying the data from the work area. So I got the data. Understood? I got the data here. Right, so I got 4970, four items. 4971, only one item is there. 4972 some 4 items or 5 items, 4973 again 4 items, 744 items, 75 again 4 items. Then what is the other range I give? 4980 to 4985. So I got the data. So this is the output I'm getting as of now. Okay, so before I continue, any questions please ask me. Before that, let me repeat once again. We have something called as ranges. What is the ranges? Ranges is similar to select options, which can hold the range of values. Ranges is similar to what? Select options. Which can hold the range of values. The difference between ranges and select options is select options generates a selection screen, allowing the user to input the range of values, whereas ranges doesn't generate the selection screen. We go for ranges when you want to fetch the data based on the fixed range. We go for ranges when you don't want the user to input the range values. In case of select options, you will have default values for sign and option, but whereas in case of ranges, explicitly we need to provide the values for what sign and what option field. So I'm fetching the data into the internal table by comparing the ranges, and then if the data is available, I'm just looping the internal table and display. So before I proceed, any questions, please ask me. No display is there for select option. For select options, I think we have no intervals and no extensions. For select options, we have no extension and no intervals. No display keyword is for parameters, not for select options, I believe. Is it there? Let me check in my previous program. I'll go to 49. Do we have select options here? No, not this one. Might be in other programs. One second. Okay, so here in this program, I use the select option with the addition no extension. So let me check whether no display is supported, because I never used it. Let me check. Select options, I'll say what, no display. Okay, let me check, save it, check it, no errors. But we are not getting the data also. It is not generating the selection screen, but we are not getting anything. One second. Select options, okay. No display. What if the addition is specified? Yeah. No display. If this addition is specified, no screen elements are created in the selection screen for the selection criteria. In an executable program, a selection criteria of this type is excluded as part of the action. It can be supplied with a value. It can be supplied with a value, which is called submit. If the addition no display is specified, the low and icon selection table can have flat data types. These selection tables can only be supplied with the data using addition with of the statement submit. So Vamshi, what I can say is if you use no display, you cannot compare with the ranges, because ranges, it is only for a particular program. If you see this program, what is it, 15? So in this program, what we have done is we have used the ranges and we must give the range values here. But what the documentation is saying is if you are using no display, it will not generate the selection screen. But what we can do is, from this program, I can call another program by using what, submit keyword. When I call another program by using submit keyword, okay, so before calling that submit keyword, we have to prepare an internal, we have to prepare the selection table by preparing these values and then pass it to other program. So what I can say is, no display addition we use as part of select option. When you're calling a program from what? One program, when you're calling a program from another program. So that's what the documentation is saying here. Here you can see once again, what it's saying is, you can see screen options, no display. If this addition is specified, no screen elements are created in the selection screen. That is understood. It is not generating the selection screen, okay? What it is saying is here, it can be supplied with a value by the calling program where it is called with what, submit. We already know the purpose of submit keyword. Submit keyword is used for what, calling a program for another program. So before, to that calling program or to that called program, I need to pass the range of values. Okay, to the called program, we need to pass the range of values. So that range of values, it seems that we will pass something like this with the selection table. So we need to prepare an internal table of what type? RS params. We need to prepare internal table of type RS params. Okay, and this RS params will hold the range of values. Means, you can see here, sign option low I, done, so and so. So my understanding is something like this here. This is my calling program. And this is called program. Calling program and what? Called program. So in this calling program, what I am using here, I'll say select options. Okay, so and so, but I'll use addition what? No display. So since I said no display, it will not generate the selection screen. So if you take this point, yes, it is similar to ranges. Ranges also will not generate selection screen. Select option with the no display addition also will not generate the selection screen. But when do we go for this no display? It seems it is saying that here we need to prepare. We need to prepare what? Internal table of type what? We need to prepare internal table of type what? RS params. RS params. Then you have to say submit. Assume that this program name is program 2. Program 2. So here you will say submit program 2 with what? RS params. What these RS params will hold? RS params will hold what? Range of values. So we are preparing this range of values not for this source program. We are preparing that range of values for the target program. So in the target program, what we will do whenever we call the using submit, control goes here. So we will read this RS params. Based on this, we'll retrieve the data. So in this program, what you'll do, you'll read the data based on what? Based on what? RS params. We'll read the data based on RS params passed from where? Passed from calling program. Okay, but whereas in case of ranges, what you are doing, it will not generate the selection screen. But this range of values are used to fetch the data for the current program only. Here two programs are not involved. Here two programs are involved. So we need to prepare internal table of type what? RS forms. RS forms also contains what field? Sign option low I. We'll do something like this. Is it clear to everyone? Vamshi, is it clear? Okay. So ranges, we must prepare the values. We must prepare the values and use these range values for the current program only. For the current program only. Here what you are doing, we are preparing the range of values not for the current program. We are passing that range to the target program. So whenever the target program is loaded, in the target program, we need to fetch the data based on what? RS firm structure, which is passed from where? Calling program. If you take only this point, yes, this will not generate the selection screen. Ranges also will not generate the selection screen. But in case of ranges, we need to prepare that range of values for fetching the data for the current program. For the current program, only one program is involved. Here, two programs are involved. So we'll suppress this. And then what we'll do? We'll prepare the internal table of type what? RS params. And then we'll submit the target program with this particular RS params internal table, which will be what? Which will call the called, which will call the other program. When the other program is getting loaded, we need to read the data based on this RS params passed from what? Calling program. That is what is the understanding. I'll do one thing. I'll try to frame an example. I'll discuss tomorrow because this is a good point. We'll discuss this scenario tomorrow. Okay. Right. Where we are now? So we got the data. We got the data, but this is not my expected output requirement. What is my requirement? Sales document should be displayed only once. Sales document should be displayed only once. And before that, I want some title to be displayed here. Okay, what is the title I am getting here? The title which was given during the program creation. So what I'll do here, I'll say what? No standard page heading, which will suppress what? Default title display. It has suppressed. Then what I want at the beginning of the first record, I want some title, something like this. So as part of this loop end loop, we can use something called as control break events. One of the control break event is what? At first. At first, I'll say right. I want to start from 15th space. I'll say something sales document item data. Sales documents item data. Item data what? With the prices. Something like this. Okay. End for at first is what? Ended. Done. Okay. So when I execute this. At first event means whenever you are processing the first record in the internal table, this event is triggered. So when I execute, yes, I got the heading here. Sales document item data with prices. Understood? First, for the first record only, this event is triggered, not for the rest of the records. Then what is the next requirement here? The sales document should be displayed only what? Once. So here the sales document is getting what? Repeated. Okay, it should be displayed only once. So what I'll do here, I'll say what? At new, what is that? At new what? VBLM. Okay, here I should not give the work area name, directly I have to give the field. At new weblen means whenever a new value is encountered for a weblen, I need to display it. So I'll say right, I'll say something sales document number is what is that? W underscore what? Sales items, W underscore sales items hyphen what? Weblen. Ended. Let me give some color formatting. Format color 3. Here I'll close it. Format color off. Done. Okay. Here I should not display the weblen once again. I'll display it from the fifth space. Let me give some color for this, for unique identification. Format color 7 and format color off. Format color off. Okay, save it. Check for the syntax done. Yeah, so what is this at new weblen? It is similar to on change of event. Okay, at new weblen is similar to what? On change of event. Okay, on change of event is triggered whenever a there is a change in the given field value. Similarly, whenever there is a new value is encountered for the field, this atenu event is triggered. The difference between atenu and on change is atenu event can be used only inside loop end loop, whereas on change of event can be used in what any of the looping statement. I can use in select and select, I can use it in loop end loop, I can use it in while end while, all those things. But whereas atenu only inside what loop and end loop. So when I execute now, see the result now. Here also I'll give some color kind of thing. Format color one. I'll close it. I'll say format color off. So when I execute, yeah. Okay, so I got the sales document number only once. Below that, I got the item data. This has got only one item, something like this. Okay. So atenu is similar to what on change of event. Whenever there's a change in this weblen value, this event will be triggered. In that event, we are displaying the weblen value. So 4970 is repeating how many times? 4 times. Only for the first record, only this event will be triggered like that. Then what is the next requirement? At the end of every sales document, I should do the sum of the net value, na? At the end of what? Every sales document. So here, somewhere here after displaying this, I'll say at the end of, there is another event called as what? At the end of event, I'll say sum, and I'll say write, and I'll just give some color kind of thing, format color 6. I'll say net value of W underscore sales items hyphen weblen is what is that? W underscore sales items hyphen what? NETWR. So let me check whether I'll get the result or not. Format color off, end for at the end of, you got at the end, end it. So when I execute, yeah, I got the data. Net value of 4970 is 32,838. So what is the understanding here? You are simply saying sum at the end of weblen means this 4970 is having how many items here? 3 items. So at the end of those 3 items, this event is triggered. What you are doing here, sum. What this sum will do? Sum will do the sum of numeric fields of the corresponding rows and stores a sum value within the same field. I repeat, sum will do the sum of the numeric fields of the corresponding rows and stores a sum value in the same field. Suppose 4970, how many records are the 3 records? If you assume this also has numeric value, what it will do? 10 plus 20 plus 30, how much? 60. That 60 is stored in what? Same field. If you assume this also has a numeric field, it will do the sum. What is the sum of this 6000? And this 6000 is stored in the same field. Here we should not say sum of so and so field. Sum, what it will do? It will do the sum of all the numeric fields of the corresponding rows and stores the sum value within the same field. That is the reason I'm just printing that field itself, which will contain the sum value within this event. Once you come out of this event, the sum value will be destroyed from this field. I repeat, sum statement, what it will do? It will do the sum of numeric fields of the corresponding rows and stores a sum value within the same field. So if you take this one, if you assume this has a numeric field, this also has a numeric field, 10 plus 20 plus 30 is 60. That 60 is stored in the same field. So if you want to print this sum value, you have to print what? POSNR. It will get the sum value provided if it is considered a numeric field. Again, if this is a sum, it will do the sum of these 3 rows, stores at some value within the same field. We need to display that field within that event. Once you come out of that event, the value would be what? Destroyed. Okay. And this 32,838, I want to display exactly under NETWR. It is not properly aligned here. It is not properly aligned. So what I'll do, somewhere here, I'll say under, there is a statement called as under, W underscore sales items hyphen what? NETWR, because we are in the loop. So I'm using what? Under statement. Let me check whether it will display or not when I execute. Yes, it is properly aligned. It has successfully displayed under the same thing. Then at the end of all the sales documents, I want the grand total at the end of all the records. So there is another control break event called as at last. At last, simply say what sum. What this sum will do? It will do the sum of all the numeric fields of all the rows of the internal table and stores that sum value within the same field. So here I'll say format color 2, and here I'll say write grand total is what? It will store the value in the same field, sales items, hyphen what, NET, W, this also I want exactly under that, W underscore sales items hyphen NET, WR, end for at last is ended. So these four control break events, these are called as control break events, at first, at new, at the end of, at last, can be used only within loop and what, end loop. I cannot use it in other places. So if you scroll down here, I'll get the grand total. 3,35,300 is the grand total. Okay, so at the first event is triggered when you're processing the first record of the internal table. At last event is triggered whenever the last record is iterated. Whenever the last record is iterated. At a new event is similar to what? On change of event. And that event is triggered whenever a new value is encountered for given field. At the end of event is triggered at the end of the last row, at the end of the last row of that particular field combination, of that field value combination. Okay, and sum statement will do the sum of what? Numeric fields of all the corresponding rows and stores a sum value within the same field. Stores a sum value within the same field. So here, these are the differences between select options and what ranges. Let me store it in a folder. Okay, select option generates selection screen for reading the user input. Doesn't generate the selection screen. Provide values for sign and option field. Explicitly, we need to provide values for sign and option field. User can enter what? Multiple ranges on the selection screen itself. Multiple ranges needs to be appended in the ranges internal table in the program itself. They are the differences between select options and what? Ranges. Okay. And at any event and on chain of event are similar. The only difference is on chain of event can be used in any of the looping statements, whereas at any event can be used only within loop and what? End loop. So any questions, please ask me. Done. So I'll wind off for today. Tomorrow we'll continue with other report requirements. Chalo.